I am Ranveer Singh.
I feel incredibly blessed to be where I am today. Films are revered in India. So every young person in India wants to be a hero. You know, in India, they don't call them actors, they call them heroes. And for somebody in my position, an outsider, it was near to impossible to actually get a foot into the Hindi film industry, because you could only become a leading man if you had a familial connection, or if you were the son of a producer or a director, or you were a star kid. If you think about it realistically, I couldn't get there. Around the age of 15, I sort of abandoned my dream of becoming an actor and I pursued becoming a copywriter. I went to America to study advertising. I think in the second year, by chance, I took an acting course. And on the first day, the instructor said, "I don't want to know who you are or where you're from. I just want you to get up in front of the class and perform." And when I went up and I started reciting a famous monologue, and it was in Hindi, and nobody in the class understood Hindi, but I said it with a great deal of passion. So everybody was taken aback.
And when I saw that I could perform
and evoke an emotional reaction out of a viewing audience, it was beautiful.
I felt that rush.
And I sat back in my seat and I said, why am I not doing this? I can accept failing, but I can't accept not trying. So I called my dad and I said, this is what I want to do. So I tried to join a theater group. No theater group wanted me, but I used to make myself useful. I used to pull up chairs for people and bring the actors tea, turn the lights off, till the point that I became indispensable to that theater group. I used to put the set up, break the set down, load big trunks into the truck. I was basically the runner. And I remember sitting outside and they said, oh, you know what? There's a film being shot next door. And I was like, what am I doing here? So I had to make a calling card, what they call the actor's portfolio, you know, headshots. I pulled a favor from my father's friend who had a printing press. I would go to his place in the middle of the night, take those pictures, make them myself. I used to steal numbers from people's phones to call filmmakers. I used to go from office to office, waiting for them all day, give my portfolio hope that I'd get a call back. I faced a lot of rejection, a lot of humiliation. It was a difficult period. I had dedicated my life to this and it just seemed like it would never happen. I don't know what was driving me. I think it was just self-belief. I believed that I was good. And one day I got a call and they said, it's for this audition. And they were actually looking for a new face. This is it. This is the day you've been waiting for. It's right there and you have to seize it. There is a Gurudwara on the way. I went to that Gurudwara and that audition went well. The biggest break that one could possibly imagine, I had just got. My legs gave way and I slumped down to my knees. And I started bawling. And I'll never forget that day. We celebrated, we danced, and then I did the movie, and it became a hit. There was just an avalanche of attention. They were like, who's this new guy? He's an amazing actor. And it was overnight. Friday the movie released, on Monday I was famous. And the next thing you know, I find myself at an awards function, receiving the best debut award from a mega star. It was like a dream. When I'm on a film set, at least once a day, I have some experience, like some fan interaction or a moment on the film set, or something happens. Almost every day, it gives me that same surreal feeling, which makes me feel like I'm living a dream. I guess that's what you get for pursuing your passion and being brave about it.